Hi, my name is Paul Mason, and today I'm going to talk a little bit about the cause of the seasons. So everyone is familiar with winter, spring, summer, and fall. And we've heard of these dates, the autumn equinox, the spring equinox, summer solstice, winter solstice. What exactly do those mean, and how does this all connect up with the tilt of the Earth and the orbit of the Earth around the Sun? So we'll make it dark and see that I will always keep the North Pole of the Earth. We see the axis tilt here, 23.5 degrees. I will always keep it pointed toward Polaris, which is in that direction. So if the sun is coming from your left, we would see the Earth look like this from space. And as the Earth turns, we could see the North Pole always stays in the sunlight. In fact, much of the northern hemisphere has very long periods of daylight and only short periods of nighttime every time the Earth spins. And so this is what we call the summer, and specifically the summer solstice on this day where the pole would be lined up in the direction of the sun. Now, as time progresses, and this is about June 21st, as this progresses throughout the year, the Earth makes an orbit around the sun. And so when this happens, the Earth moves around this way. So like this, up until the point in which it is perpendicular to the line of sight of the pole. So the axis still pointing to Polaris, but you see the sun is coming from an angle about 90 degrees to that. And so as the Earth spins now, it, at all places on the Earth, we see 50% daylight, 50% nighttime. And this is what we call the equinox, which comes from the meaning of equal night, or equal day and night. And this happens twice, and we have the spring equinox. And the spring equinox happens between the winter solstice and the summer solstice. And so we began with the summer solstice, so this is the autumnal equinox or the fall equinox. And so if we keep going, the Earth orbits around the sun. And so in our model, we would have to move around this way, always keeping the pole pointed to Polaris. We see as the Earth spins, now it's the southern hemisphere that's getting daylight. And in fact, Antarctica, the continent at the South Pole, and receives light at all times. Even as the Earth spins, the sun never sets. But for places north of that, in Australia, New Zealand, Africa, and South America, we see in the southern part of Africa, at least, is below the equator, and those areas get more than 12 hours of light, less than 12 hours of darkness at this time, so this is the winter solstice, which is about December 21st, approximately every year. And the dates will change. Sometimes when we have leap years, the dates are a little bit different. And even depending upon where you, what time zone you're in, the time and the date of the equinox or solstice can change. So that can be looked up on a calendar for the year in particular. And so we can move around to the last position, which is here, and that's hard to see from your point of view.